Hello guys, and welcome to Python programming tutorials by Amul's Academy. In the previous tutorial we discussed about the for loop. In this tutorial we are discussing about the while loop. Okay, first we'll see the syntax of while loop. While and condition. Okay, then statements. Okay, this is the syntax of while loop. Now we'll see the example for while loop. First, we'll create one variable and I'll assign the value as 1. And now I'll use while count is less than or equal to 5. If that is true, then I'll print the count and I'll increment the count. Here I'll come out of the loop and I'll print one message, it is goodbye. Now I'll save this, I'll run this. Now we can see the output as 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 and goodbye. First, the value of count is 1. So it will check whether 1 is less than or equal to 5. Yes, it is true. So it will print the value, that is 1. Now it will comes to this statement, that is count is equal to count plus 1. Actually count value was 1 here, that is 1 plus 1, so 2. Now the count value is 2 here, so it will again go to the while loop and it will check whether 2 is less than or equal to 5. Yes, it is true, so it will print the value 2. Next, again it will come to this statement and now the count value is 2 here, so 2 plus 1, answer is 3. Now the value of count is 3 and it will again go to the while loop, that is it will check the condition 3 is less than or equal to 5. Yes, it is true, so it will print the value. Now again it will come to this statement, count value was 3, so 3 plus 1, answer is 4. Now the value of count is 4. Again control goes to the while loop, 4 is less than or equal to 5. Yes, it is true, so it will print the value 4. Again it will come here and 4 plus 1 here, so value is 5. Now the count value is 5 here. Again it will go to the while loop and 5 is less than or equal to 5. Yes, it is true, because 5 is equal to 5, so it will print the value 5 and it will come here. Here 5 plus 1, value is 6, so now the count value is 6. Again it will go to the while loop, 6 is less than or equal to 5. No, it is not, so it will terminate the loop. So it will come out from this loop and it will execute the next instruction, that is print goodbye. That's why we got answer as 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 and goodbye. Okay, this is example for while loop. This is also called as an indefinite loop because before execution, here we know how many times this instruction will execute. Because here count is 5, so here we can tell that 5 times instruction will repeat. We can see 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. But in some other cases before execution, we can't tell about how many times the instruction will execute. That types of loops are called as indefinite loops. This is the finite loop, that is once the condition becomes false, it will terminate the loop. But if we didn't include this statement, that is an increment statement, then this will lead to the infinite loop, that is I'll execute this. We can see the output 1, 1, 1, 1, 1 and it's going on. It's because when it will check the condition, count is 1, 1 is less than or equal to 5. Yes, it is true. So it will print the value. There is no increment or decrement statement. Next, the control goes to the while loop. Now the value of count is same, that is 1. So again it will check, again it will print, again it will check, again it will print. So there is no way to come out of this loop. So this is called as infinite loop. Okay, this is about the while loop. Okay, that's it for now. Thank you for watching. I'll meet you in next class. Till then, take care.